What's happening, my beautiful people? My name is Dirty Mike. We're back to the ultimate journey. Yeah, I'm staring you down on the other end. If you want more Road to Glory, drop a thumbs up and I will have some things for you guys to vote on in the comments down below. Get your fitness squad or your overpowered cheap teams on deck. I've got a big announcement. My second channel is back into action. It's no longer out of commission. And I dropped a video that includes running from the cops, having some bad driving, and a lot of crazy stuff. I don't want to spoil anything, but I'm going to leave links in the description as well as on screen. You know, go show me some love, drop some feedback. I want to be as transparent as possible, and I believe that vlogs and skits will allow me to do so. And I'm looking forward to what you guys got for me in the comments. I did a giveaway last week for SteelSeries Dirty Mike attire. You can't purchase it, absolutely free. Chose a couple names at random, and here they are. Congratulations to both Nate from Idaho, as well as Evan from North Carolina. I need you guys to YouTube inbox me, or let me know on Twitter so we can get those addresses. I can send it out, and no, I did not discriminate. I did everything at random. I know it's a couple Americans, but trust, everybody is welcome in any of my giveaways. I do not exclude. We don't play favoritism over here. If you need any coins, or you wanna pick up any codes, then go ahead and get involved at FIFA Coin Zone or G2A. The links are in the description. Use Dirty at checkout. You can skip through the trading methods. You can just get it all in there one time. Ah, here we go. And as you can see on screen, we got 14,000 coins to start off the episode. And I'm still selling bronze items, bronze players from some of the bronze packs I invested in the previous episode. I always encourage you guys to start from the beginning and work with me. You wanted the Heskey Skill Squad, and this is what I came up with. We got Wellington on the wings. We got Bolasie on the wings. Chemistry is okay at an 88. We're using the loaned legend, Sol Campbell. And I'm feeling somewhat confident heading into divisional play. In Division 10, I should be able to get away with a non-perfect squad. A team that is still building. A team that we're still figuring it out with. Right? As we start the match and... bangs down the post. We've got a lot to talk about, and I want to address the bronze pack method, because if you don't have a lot of time, I don't think this method is valuable. However, if you have the ability to put in a few hours every single day to FIFA, or you're able to check the web app repeatedly, then you can open tons of bronze packs and you can relist, because it's going to take ages to sell everything. However, can you profit? Will you profit? Most likely. But it's a grind. Look at Heskey. Uh-oh. Look at the footwork. Can you finish? Ah, we're on the board! 47th minute. It took me a little while to get everything flowing and glowing. But once you get one, two is always on the horizon with the deep shot. And ooh, just wide of the post. And I want to talk about how to make slow players more valuable on your squad, as we get a lovely through ball. And off the crossbar, finesse shot. Heskey did not celebrate. He actually just fell over. He's getting kind of up there in age. Already his second goal. And I was not looking to use and abuse with Heskey. You see that? No touch. Look at this. Oh, no, no. It's unbelievable. I was not looking to make Heskey a star, but he's going to take over this episode. I don't want to give too many spoilers, but trust in Heskey. We're going to score some goals. 3-0. He has an opening hat trick. Finch would be proud. But with slower players, if they have 2 or 3 star skills, look to use that fake shot, as we are going to loan a player. They didn't give me good options, not helpful ones. I go with Snyder. Maybe I can use him off the bench. I know he's not that expensive. I just didn't feel that any of the other players were that valuable. We're still relisting bronze players. And I want to showcase or display everything that I'm doing in FIFA. In this series, you're going to see it all, and you guys could go ahead and play along as we're going up against a 5-2-1-2. I wasn't happy when I saw this, because 5 at the back, Division 10, full gold team. Ah, that's got bad news written all over that. Heskey moving kind of slow, but look at the finish! The left foot of dreams, and he taps his right foot. He's just being a cocky dude. But it just touches the post. And we've got Rakitic, my opponent. He lines up a free kick. Are we foreshadowing something? Pretty solid save there. We still haven't upgraded our goalkeeper, and I'm going to have a lot of different voting options for you guys in the comments. It reminds me of when we did Fatal. Everybody seemed to really enjoy the Fatal series, and I want to bring that to the Road to Glory, where you guys have the direct impact, and it all started with that Heskey skill squad.
as we get a bit of an own goal, some good fortune. He should have finished the initial opportunity. I was not impressed with Wellington, especially not for the price range. I believe I spent, and how is that not a penalty kick? I believe I spent about 76 or 7,800 coins for him. And that's just because he's a silver with 5-star skills, but he was nothing extraordinary. He was not a big, impactful performer. Nothing to go home and tell your mom about. Maybe you tell your sister, but not your mom or your dad. Not the guys that put you on the map. You're not going to tell them about it. As we're up 2-0, halftime, still feeling confident, starting to wiggle out some of the skills. Look at Bolasie. And if you can get his inform card, I highly recommend it. It's a position change. It's going to be a center attacking mid. And his shooting gets a little bit better. His finishing gets a little bit better. That's one of the downfalls as Heskey turns and unleashes. And we've got another goal. And he's got a good weak foot. And he has the finishing trait, no doubt about it. Hold up, though. Let me rewind. So if you have slower players and they have 2 or 3-star skills, look towards the fake shot and the ball roll. It can increase speed. It can also give them a little bit more time on the ball if you need to hold up for just a second to play that extra pass or to get the correct shooting angle. And if you have a 4-star skiller, I believe in the Elastico. It just seems to give them a speed burst or the advanced spin. So if you guys want to use slower players and they've got some skill, or even if they don't, there is still the opportunity to put them into squads and to be effective. Now, if you're one of those players that just runs an ultimate team, all right, it might not work for you. So we're making some halftime changes. I wasn't liking that. To be in a 0-0 game in Division 10, nothing to go home and brag to your friends about. They're not going to be happy if that's the situation. But, well, we get a little Berba. We pull it back. And we got the scoop. Oh, my goodness. Bolasie with the weak foot. A little bit of some additional razzle-dazzle. And the fake Rabona into the scoop turn has got to be one of my favorite skill combinations. If you guys want to see a video covering some of my favorite skill combinations, drop a thumbs up or hit me in the comments. Actually, hit me in the comments. Let me know that video needs to happen. As you see the L2, R2 dribble, something I use and abuse almost every single match heavily. I definitely use that skill every game, but I might use it as much as 15, 20, 30 times per match because everyone's capable and you can find a little bit more holes in the pitch, a little more space. As we're giving Juan Jesus a contract, I've always rated him. And we've got to get rid of Sol Campbell. Fortunately, I have a Brazilian center back on the bench, and we go ahead and grab Barkley, who I'm a big fan of. I'm also thinking of linkage here. We've only got 370 coins after making that purchase, but Lallana and Barkley are now interchangeable. And it's just a matter of how we put together the final squad. And I've had a couple bronze fitness cards that I was able to apply on players if you're wondering, hey, Mike, how are your players not getting more tired, not more drawn out? Remember I opened those bronze packs. I held onto the fitness cards, and that's giving me an option. This might be the best goal. Wow. That is impeccable. He's got a Thunderfoot. I don't know how many goals Heskey has thus far. This guy is... Inform would be an understatement. If we can get an inform Heskey this year at Bolton, what? Good things would happen. But yes, please let me know about the skill move combinations. As you see here, we've got some defensive errors. Pretty close to knocking that in. The bar is our savior. But this opponent was much better than a Division 10 player, or I just wasn't on my A game as much in this match. I didn't play an outstanding first half. It's 1-1. He probably deserved the equalizer. I'm not going to take anything away from him. However, it's the main man. What can he do? Oh, he sticks out his neck! Ooh, and he falls over again. He's tired, but I'm not mad at him. He's climbing, and he's defying gravity. I don't know how this is possible. But he's so physical. I truly rate Heskey. Not in a Division 1 squad builder. Not in a team where he has to do everything and make it happen. But in a lower division where you've got a 6-silver squad and you're going against other silver teams, it'll be alright as we get a rage quit. Happy days. Can't be mad about that. And that advances us. We are now out of Division 10. We get a little bit of a coin bonus. Look at Heskey. Right? 4 games played, 8 goals and an assist. What else could you ask for with 44 pace? He's walking around. I sold Silva because I wasn't impressed, and I'm still relisting bronze players. I'm at 10,000 coins, and this is where things are going to get special. They're going to get interesting. I hope you stuck around. I need your votes in the comments. And up top, I want to go ahead and hold on to Heskey for the series, but we need to get another option. So we got Origi or Welbeck. And then I have Hernandez or Melo. And then I've got Stones or Cogner, because that allows me to be interchangeable, as I was saying, with Alana, who I love this year. I think he's a good player. If he was a little bit quicker, had a little bit better shot, that would be perfect with the 5-star weak foot, the 4-star skill moves. And then we've got Barkley, a new signing. And here, link up, get that strong power link with Stones. But let me know in the comments if you enjoyed the series. As always, drop a thumbs up, subscribe, and I have a lot more coming. I plan on getting this out every Monday and Wednesday at 9 a.m., USA Central Time, or 3 p.m. UK. I realize it's today's Tuesday. I'll probably have another episode out on Friday, and it's going to be on that same time period. I've just been struggling to get everything edited, especially with the longer episodes. I never know if things are going to sell or not so much. And if you have trading methods, please, put that in the comments. I'd love to include that in an EP, whether it worked, it didn't work, it made some coins, we got some luck, whatever it might be. But I'm looking forward to it. Let's make some upgrades.